is coming up. Quita?
Albert, thank you very much. Now, it's a subject on the minds of many Americans and a hot-button issue for debate, the nation's health care system. So what's happening in Washington when it comes to quality health care for all? Well, joining us this morning is Republican Texas Congressman Micah McCaul to talk a little bit more about it. Thank you so much for being with us.
Well, thank you.
Well, I know all lawmakers agree that coverage should be affordable and available for everyone, but no one can really agree on a firm way to make that happen.
Well, we all agree it should be more affordable and accessible to every American, and reforms need to take place. But I believe this bill is not the right way to do it. This is essentially the same bill that they dropped before the August recess. And you may recall we all went home to our districts. In my view, the majority of the American people don't support this. Certainly in my district, on my website, I have a poll, and it's about 85% against this, what's called the public option or the government run option, the government takeover of our health care. It's 1/6 of our economy. And we think there are ways to reform the system, whether it's portability of health insurance, some insurance reforms, the idea of pooling across state lines, risk pooling, and the idea of providing tax incentives to small businesses and individuals to purchase health care insurance. This bill, on the other hand, it's about 2,000 pages, excuse me, it's filled with mandates, punitive measures, tax increases on small businesses and individuals at a time when really our economy can least afford it. In fact, the president's chief economic advisor, according to his model, said that this bill will cost 5.5 million jobs in the United States. And that's not good news for this economy.
Definitely not. And of course, the health care issue, it's not something that can be rushed either. And I know many lawmakers and Americans feel like that's exactly what's happening.
I think, we feel like there's this arbitrary deadline with a gun to our head, and they're going to put it on the floor probably next week, up or down vote. I visited with all the hospitals and doctors across my district. I went to the Texas Medical Center. President of MD Anderson said point blank, this bill, this public option, government-run option, will destroy American medicine. And he said our hospitals may go out of business. And that's pretty strong language. It wasn't my language. It was language coming from the top experts in the nation. And he said, why didn't the Congress talk to us? Before you pass all this huge monster of a bill, why didn't the Congress talked to us? Not one witness testified before the committee. In 1 week, it was marked up and it got out. And I think that's a fair question from the healthcare professionals and the doctors that, look, we have expertise, and why didn't Congress listen to the experts?
Now, I know you're co-sponsoring H.R. 3218, the Improving Healthcare for All Americans Act. Why do you think this is really a viable alternative to the Democrats' government-run option?
Well, because it incentivizes the free market and the private sector to provide coverage without these punitive mandates that we find in the Democrats' bill. It also doesn't have this government-run takeover and this big federal health commission, this health czar that's going to be making all these decisions regarding our health and getting between you and your doctor. And I don't think that's what most Americans want. Our bill basically, again, provides tax incentives for small businesses and individuals to purchase it. Doesn't penalize them as this bill does. It allows insurance companies to pool risk across state lines, driving competition, driving the cost down. Tort reform, defensive medicine that's practiced. We have medical liability reform. We have a pretty good law in the United States. This would make that nationwide to drive down the cost of providing health coverage. So there are a lot of good ideas. Portability. Pre-existing conditions can't be disqualified to get that. There are a lot of great ideas out there, but we're just not given a seat at the table. I mean, this is all being run behind closed doors in Washington with a very few selected number of lawmakers calling all the shots on this. And this is the product that they came out with, and I think this is not the right course for America.
All right, Congressman McCaul, thank you very much
for
being with us. We appreciate
it. Happy Halloween to you.
Happy Halloween to you, too.